In this photogrammetry tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can quickly capture a 3D mesh of yourself or another person, a full body scan with just a few photos. This will not create a perfect scan, but it'll create a scan in just a few moments that has textures and is able to be used in animations and other 3D projects. To do this, we're going to use a software called Photocatch. To get Photocatch, you can go to Photocatch in a web browser. If you type Photocatch into a search engine, this site will pop up in the Mac App Store. Then you need to open it in the App Store. Then, if you haven't installed it, go ahead and install it. It's a free app. It is a free app with in-app purchases, but we can use all the functionality we need with the free version. Go ahead and open Photocatch. When you open Photocatch, you're greeted with this dialog. You're able to create a 3D model from photos or a video. The video option is really great. If you just need to capture an object real quick, you can capture a video that goes around the object, and then it can select the various frames you need to make the 3D model through photogrammetry. This is really good for fast-moving objects like people, but sometimes when you're using a video, you may not have the right shutter speed and you may get blurry images. The other way to do it is with photos. With photos, you can simply take pictures around the object that you're taking from different angles and then use those. We're going to use this option right now, so we'll select photos. And then here I have a folder of photos. These photos have the character that is moving around on a turntable. It's best to have a nice clean background with your photos. This is not necessary. You can get very good scans without having a clean background. But once you have your photos selected, then bring them into Photocatch, and then you can quickly do a preview by selecting Create Model. So Photocatch quickly makes a preview of your model. This is a good idea to do because it allows you to see if there's anything wrong with your photos. So for example, sometimes you may move your arm a lot and it may be really distorted in the first capture. But if you have a pretty solid object, meaning that all the parts are basically where they're supposed to be in preview mode, that means you can probably go ahead and do a more exact photogrammetry reconstruction of the mesh in Photocatch. I'm going to close this. Once again, I'll select my photos. It's a folder of photos with Photocatch. And then I have different options. I can go all the way up to raw, which will create a very high poly count mesh. Usually high is plenty good for what you need. And then under the advanced tab is if you're having problems with unordered, sometimes if you've definitely taken your pictures in order, you can select sequential. So depending on how it goes, Photocatch recommends using unordered first and then changing that. Enable object masking allows Photocatch to delete everything else in the scene. If you want to have the background and other objects, then uncheck this. So let's go ahead and do a high level model, and then we'll create our model. Once Photocatch gets done processing your model, you can see that with the high setting, we get a much better model. We still have some areas that we obviously need to clean up, but this is a pretty good model, and we can see what we need to have in our 3D scene. Now, one thing that happens if you're using a green screen background, you can see all this green spill, so you can experiment with removing that green ahead of time. So for example, here in Blender, I have two versions of the same scan. So this one over here has the original photos with the green. This one here, I removed the green first in Photoshop. Each has its pluses and minuses when you're doing photogrammetry. I think the textures on this model on the right are much better and much more true to life and color. But because it removes some of the pixel information, then Photocatch has a bit harder time putting everything together. Although I do think it's fine down in the pants where it doesn't move, it does lose some detail up in the upper body where it doesn't have the same type of solid scanning. So for example, if I switch to mesh, you can see here that this mesh is a little bit better up here than this one. But down here, I think they both do really well. This may have a few more artifacts, but I think because the shoes really aren't moving, that either method works well. But if I go ahead back to render preview, you can see that this one has problems by the hand right here. And then if we look at this one, we can see more of the hand. Now you would need a much more detailed scan and many more photos and longer processing time to get more detail than that. But I think this is great for being able to use quickly in 3D animations, video games, and other fun 3D modeling projects. So hopefully this allows you to use a folder of photos to create a 3D model with Photogrammetry and Photocatch.